Hello, hello, my friends. Happy almost summer. It's been a hot minute and I'm so happy to find the time to sit here and chat with you guys and talk about this latest buy that I got. By the title of the video, you already know what I'm talking about. So we're gonna go in depth about this little sandal of mine, my feelings about it, my feelings when I first received it versus now, which has been probably around 10 days since I've had the sandal. And I wanted to share all my feelings with you guys and a full review, comfort level, quality level, style level, all of the good stuff that you guys know you can find here in my reviews. So I hope you're ready for this. Let's do this. Okay guys, so this is the Gucci sandals that I am going to be reviewing today. So this is a little overview of them. If you're watching this, you're probably debating or contemplating purchasing this, and I have a lot to share. So first of all, it comes in, so there's like the big canvas bag that I love, because these guys, I mean, you can take them anywhere, everywhere. I usually do like my shopping with this, or like at the mall, return clothing, you know, just like carry things that are like a lot, and it just looks a little nicer, you know, a little more stylish, right? I think little canvas, but I don't know, all about that, you know, avoiding to pick up bags or paper bags every store that we go to. Then big box in here. Now I'm loving the Gucci boxes as of late. It used to be that black and white style that I still have, but this is just a lot more sturdy, just super pretty. Overall, the packaging presentations, you know, amazing. Like little ribbon in here. The receipt comes in the envelope. Cool thing this time around, I've noticed that they actually sent the sandals in this, like a muslin bag, or yeah, a muslin bag, and then the nice garment bag, or in this case, shoe bag. So I just thought it was so cool because, you know, you might want to use this for something else, like, I don't know, like I can think of a million things, like put your socks, or when I travel, I like to put my underwear or bathing suits, or like little things that, you know, keep them put together and, you know, has a nice little presentation to it. And then you can keep your actual shoe that gets dirty and yucky in the little muslin bag. So kudos for Gucci for thinking of this. It's something I've never even, I don't know, crossed my mind, but it's just a nice little touch that I wanted to share with you guys. Now for the sandal itself, you guys, this is made of 100% rubber. Whoops! It does have quite a few little details that I personally appreciate, like the little Gucci logo in here. It's very discreet, but definitely there. It is like the logo on the buckle as well, as you can see up here. The buckle is actually quite sturdy and nicely made. I had to fidget with them because I had to, you know, like make the straps a little bit looser for me. And so it's just, you know, it's nice. It has some quality in there. The Velcro in here, you know, there's like a Velcro, which I'm not personally a big fan of Velcro sandals. It kind of makes it look like a little kid's sandal. That's my first impression of it. Or perhaps a glorified Birkenstock, which you're probably thinking the same thing. However, I think I would have liked better if it didn't have the back part in here, but it is actually cute. So there's a cute level in it that's, and I don't know if it's just growing on me, because it has definitely grown on me since I've gotten it. First, I wore this for 5 minutes and I was like, no, it's gonna go back. It's, I'm returning, you know, wore it around the house to get a feel for it. And I'm like, no, this sandal, this 100% rubber sandal glorified Birkenstock needs to be comfortable. It's a plastic sandal, right? What's the purpose of it? So that, with that said, I just kept on looking back at it and I'm like, but it is so cute, but it is so cute. And people are loving it. It's just selling like hotcakes right now. So I gave it a try, and then I fidgeted with the straps in here and I made them looser, and they are a lot more comfortable. I am a size 8.5 in the US size, and I got the 38. I feel like I would have been better off with the 39. So just a side note on the side in its sizing in there, because it does fit my foot like perfectly, but there's not very much room for playing in here. So I think that it would have been more comfortable with the 39. I'm just not gonna go through the trouble of exchanging them, because I have worn them quite a bit around the house too. I mean, never outside, but it's, you know, it's mine. I'm keeping it, so whatever it is, it's not bad. Once I've changed this, I just wish it was more comfortable for the price point. This guy here retails for $590, so quite expensive, but I'm guessing because it is sold out in so many places already, I'm not sure it's gonna be back in stock, probably at the Gucci website. But if not, they're gonna come back next year and it will be more expensive. I'm pretty sure about it. So just, or maybe not, I don't know. Anyway, back to the description, because I'm getting sidetracked in here. There is a little Gucci logo on the back of it as well. So super cute little detail. It does come in other colors. I personally do not like the other colors. This is the white they're calling, but it is more of like a creamy ivory, which I like it even better. So as far as quality, like I said, it is a plastic and rubber. There, it does have good quality. Like the stitching is pretty nicely done. There's no like glue sticking out or anything like that. The sole, it's pretty foamy. The only thing, and this is the funny thing, because Birkenstocks, I know you guys, I don't know if you're a fan or not. I personally never liked them. I've tried to like them because it was so big at some point, but it's just not my cup of tea. And so I'm thinking, this is probably not gonna be this, it's probably gonna be the same for me. One of the biggest reasons why I don't like Birkenstocks is because they're so uncomfortable on my foot. Like the sole, it just hits me wrong. And I'm like, there's no point. The sandal is hideous in my opinion, and it's just not comfortable either. So this is what my thoughts were on this shoe, is like, is it worth it? But like I said, the foam here is so much more comfortable than an actual Birkenstock. So in the style, in my opinion, is very, very cute as well. So I had a one of my readers asking, she was actually quite mad. I can't remember exactly her words, but she was just like, I just don't get this. This is stupid. Why do you spend so much money on something like this? You know, and this and this and that, can you tell me what's the hype? And here's the thing, you guys, for me, I've noticed personally that when I buy designer stuff, I wear it so much more. And it could be because I want to make sure I get my money's worth of that piece. You know what I mean? So if I have a pair of Birkenstocks, say I love Birkenstocks and I have a pair of Birks in white and I have this Gucci here, which pair do you think I would be wearing the most? You guessed it right. I would, because it's like this costed like 5 times more, you know, than the Birkenstock. So I want to make sure that I'm getting all I can out of this wear. So that's one thing why I, you know, shopping, personally shopping for fast fashion in fast fashion is not my favorite thing, because it's so disposable, and things like this, you can just wear it over and over and over again. Now, to me, it's hard to justify the $590 price. I think it's because inflation is just ridiculous right now, because I have the other Gucci shoes, which I'm not sure if there's a video review on here about this guy, but I wore it to death, so much so that it's like stained. So this area here, I don't know if it's like got wet over something, and I've tried bleaching, I've tried everything, and nothing rubs it out. But despite that, this is like super comfortable, and when I made the decision of buying this, I was thinking that the sole will be just like this. This does not look comfortable, but it's a very comfortable. It's actually like, I don't know, cushiony. To me, it's a way more comfortable than this guy, even though there's a little bit of a heel in here. And this guy here is a 370, I believe. So, you know, a couple hundred dollars cheaper than this sandal here. I don't get much of as of why, maybe because there's more plastic and then there's the buckle in here, the Velcro. Yeah, I guess more details. But wore this guy so much, not so much into it like nowadays, but it was a good sandal. I still wear a lot. Anywho, but we're talking about the Little Dad Sandals. So I personally like shopping, when I'm shopping for Gucci, I like shopping directly from the Gucci website because it ships directly from there. The packaging is really, really nicely, the way that it comes. But if this is not important to you, I also recommend you buying locally or in like a Nordstrom or a Saks Fifth Avenue because it's much easier to return. With Gucci, you actually have to make a phone call and request a label and give them a reason why. I had to return a handbag not too long ago and I was like, oh, this is a little bit of a hassle. So just something to keep in mind if you're just trying to get the pair and see if you're gonna like it or not and thinking that you might return, then you might wanna go with like a major retailer. Now, if you're thinking about keeping and you like the kind of, you know, nice fancy presentation, then go with the Gucci store. Now, as far as like style goes, I feel like it does elevate any casual style. So for instance, right now, I just put this together here because I was thinking of a 4th of July little outfit and I got this sweater and some shorts and I was gonna put, I can't even remember what I was gonna put on, like flip-flops, oh, my Jordans, my like black and white or red and white Jordans. But then I saw these and I instantly put it on and I'll post a picture of it, the outfit that I have on right now, and it looks so cute. I've also worn with a knit dress, it's just a little more elevated, so it basically makes a casual outfit more elevated. Or it tones down some like a fancier outfit, but it still looks super cute and put together. This is my point of view after 10 days of trying to love this. I actually do love them, so I am excited to bring them along. I've styled them in so many ways, you guys. This is another thing too. If you're not following on Insta, make sure that you do so because I have like weekly styling videos in there, Amazon finds and all of that good stuff. But you know, I value things like this. If I'm gonna spend this amount of money, I want to make sure I'm gonna wear the heck out of it. And therefore, you know, in respect to you, if you're gonna spend this kind of money, I want you to get the most out of it. So that's why I put those videos together. Make sure that you follow so you have access to that content. I also wanted to make sure that I style this in ways that are unexpected. You know, anybody can style this with like a pair of shorts and a t-shirt, but it's the out there, like the unexpected, that I think it's so cute. I do think that the Dad Sandals are not going anywhere, so if you have been debating whether you like it or not, you should just get it because they've been going on since 2020. Started with the Chanel Dad Sandals that I found hideous, you guys. I remember I was at Saks in 2021, and yeah, last year, like during the Nordstrom sale, and the guy was like, this sandal is like selling out so quickly, like this is huge. And I looked at him and I'm thinking, are you kidding me? Like, no way, no way, Jose, thanks, no. And moved on to like a little classic sling bag or whatever, slink back. Ended up not getting either one, but it's still here. And the Chanels are like long gone because they sell out so quickly. So if you can get your hands in a pair, if you do like the designer name, I do recommend this guy here. And if not, then maybe you can, like if you don't need the designer name, there's a ton of knockoffs that are super cute, sometimes even cuter, like with suede and leather. The only ones that I refuse to use, and I've never liked them when they were, you know, a thing back in the 90s, is the little thin ones that go like this, you know, like the swimming kind. Oh my gosh, you guys, I'm never gonna be caught dead wearing something like those. But then again, never say never, because I never thought I was gonna wear something like this, and I do love them. So what's the verdict? I love them. I think that they can be worn in so many ways. I do recommend them. Maybe size up, read the reviews, and I hope that this video was helpful to you guys. I've missed you, and here's a piece of good news. Nordstrom sale is about to start, so I have a whole plan of covering the sale, just like last year. If you've been here long enough, you would know that I covered the sale, and I'm excited to be sharing with you guys everything that I'll be getting, you know, all the goods. It's fall merchandise, so my favorites. So make sure to come back and stay tuned. Like, hit the subscribe button so you get notification, like the little bell. So every time a new video goes live, you guys can be the first ones to see. And as you know, Nordstrom sale like sells out so quickly, you want to be to make sure you're the first ones to like get on it, take advantage of those deals. And until next time, my friends, I hope you have an amazing summer, and I'll see you soon. Um beijo. Tchau, tchau.